Do you remember the days where you used these, or even these, to transfer files between Windows PCs? What were we, savages? Now there's a better way, three ways in fact, to transfer files quickly, simply, and wirelessly between Windows PCs. There's three ways of sharing files, and three different scenarios. The first is Cloud Clipboard, for two PCs that you already own. The second is Nearshare, for two PCs in proximity to one another, one of which you own. And the third is traditional OneDrive sharing, for sharing large files as far away as halfway across the world. Everyone knows how to cut and paste across documents. Control X, Control C, and then Control V, and you're done. But what if you could cut and paste across PCs? That's what Clipboard, or sometimes called Cloud Clipboard, allows you to do. Now, Clipboard isn't quite here yet. It's going to be part of the fall 2018 update to Windows 10, but we can look at it in a preview mode in the Windows 10 Pro Insider Preview. And to do so, all we need to do is go into the settings, type in Clipboard, and then make sure that this particular setting, Sync Across Devices, is turned on. You'll also want to make sure that this is highlighted as well, Automatically Sync Text That I Copy. Once that's done, cutting and pasting is as easy as going into a text document, highlighting a block of text, hit Control C, go into the document on the other PC, and hit Control V, and that's it. The problem with Cloud Clipboard is that it only allows you to share a few megabytes at a time. If you want to share a web page or a larger file, you need what's called Nearshare, or nearby sharing. Now, nearby sharing is also great for the fact that you can go ahead and share with strangers who are sitting in close physical proximity. Now, to do so, you'll need to do a couple of things. Obviously, you'll need to go into the settings once again and to make sure that nearby sharing is turned on. Now, one of the things that nearby sharing also requires is it requires that you have Bluetooth and Wi-Fi turned on. That's the transport mechanism that's used to transfer files. Now, once you've done that, you can go ahead and transfer files from one PC to the next. Now, this PC right here is actually logged in under a generic Lenovo account, whereas the other PC is actually logged in under my name. So if I go into PC World's webpage and I want to say, hey, look, I want you to know about our roundup of the best graphics cards for PC gaming. Well, within Edge, there's this lovely share button up to the upper right-hand corner. You can go ahead and click it, and it'll go ahead and look for nearby devices. It's found the Surface laptop sitting nearby, so I'll go ahead and click it. And what it's doing is it's initiating a transfer protocol where on one PC it sends it over, and on the other, it opens it. So, in just a few seconds, this other PC will have an opportunity to go ahead and find out the best graphics cards for PC gaming. So what if we have a file that's a few hundred megabytes or even a few gigabytes in size? Sure, we could burn a DVD or even send a hard drive cross-country, but that's not really practical when we have a better solution, and that's Microsoft's OneDrive. Now, if you have a Windows 10 PC, and especially a subscription to Office 365, you already have a number of gigabytes. In fact, you have a terabyte of data available to you in the cloud. And on your PC, you have access to it. Now, the best way to go ahead and set it up is to go ahead and go to the taskbar, this OneDrive icon, go to the More Ellipsis menu, go into Settings, and then configure OneDrive to back up your available files on your documents, in your Documents folder, in your Photos folder, and possibly in your desktop as well. And if you do so, over time, you'll accumulate a list of files and folders like we see over here. Now, the little cloud icons next to the folders show me that those files reside in the cloud and not on my PC, and that's a good thing, actually. We don't want all of that terabyte actually clogging up our hard drive. So what happens, though, if we have a file that we've already uploaded to the cloud that we need to go ahead and send to somebody? In this case, I have a file that's 850 megabytes of raw video that I need to go ahead and send to an editor to turn into a story. So I could go ahead and, again, to try to burn a DVD and send it overnight, but that's not going to matter. That's not going to make sense in terms of my deadline. So what I want to do is I want to go ahead and use the cloud to send this file as quickly as possible. The easiest way to do that is to simply right-click it, and that brings up a menu, and I can go ahead and share a OneDrive link. And as you can see from the notification, I now have a link in my clipboard that I can send to my editor. They can go ahead and download the file and go ahead and edit it as they so choose. Well, that concludes the way in which we go ahead and share files wirelessly within Windows. I hope you've enjoyed this video, and I hope you tune into PC World for more.